beautiful. People, it's your girl Purity Washira. A little sugar and a little spice.
I know, tenting. And I go by the name Ingasian, the tall Melanie, eh? Dark and beautiful. Eh?
Yeah.
And today we are joined by
one of the most interesting people in the market, because this is where we talk about everything and anything that is trending and stylish. And when I say that, there's this thing in a trend. Kuna iwa inimekua inspired by Kenyans.
Inaitua? Muratina. Inaitua Muratina. But kwa meita Muratelia.
Yeah,
Muratelia. It's hitting UK. It's hitting everywhere. Eh? So Kenyans, we are hitting the market. So big up to Kenyans. The is it the Kikuyu community?
Of course it is.
That inspired this Muratina. Sindo?
Yeah.
So that's all we have for trends today. And our guest, our one and only designer today, Twambie jina.
Okay, first I'll start by thanking Heart Media Television for hosting me, and of course Ngasian and Anwashira. So to start with, my real name is Patrick Murigi Kinudia. it's a hard Kikuyu name. Then I have the brand with me, Don Tricks. Yeah, Don Tricks.
Wow, such an interesting name. So tell us, why Don Tricks?
Where did Don Tricks come from?
Yeah.
Okay, Don Tricks itself, it's self-explanatory, because it comprises of two words. So there is Don and Tricks.
Mm-hmm.
So Don, it's just a popular name. It's a Don. It's a boss. Yeah, it's a boss.
Wow.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Then the Tricks is a suffix of my name, Patrick, so I decided to just combine and come up with Don Tricks.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So interesting and creative.
Essentials, your name, I think your social media handles, the Don Tricks Essentials. So,
okay, essentials are something that you should own, like it's something important. So Don Tricks Essentials, it's clothes you should have, you should own.
Nice. So, yeah. It's Boss Patrick's must have.
Yeah.
Nice. That's a good name.
Very.
So what inspired you to venture into designing, Kenyan market designing? Inspired you?
Okay, to be honest, I think first I was doing it, I was starting a business, so I was trying to earn a living. Then I would say I am very passionate about fashion itself. So I like doing fashion, and yeah.
Did you study fashion?
No. I've never been to class about fashion. So it's all about what really I want to do.
So how would you define your style?
Okay, my style is inspired by a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
First, I would say that it's inspired by art scenes, of course, from music, hip hop. From vintage, from the 90s and the 80s, and of course day-to-day life, maybe various professionals, including maybe like how garage workers dress, or something like that. And of course the climate itself, so the change in the weather and everything, I might come up with everything I want to design.
So when you talk about your style, is it something that somebody can wear when going to a professional thing, casual?
Yeah.
Tell us, where does it fall?
Okay, my style, it's mainly street fashion, but I can do everything. Everything. I can style someone who is going to the office, someone who is a sportsman.
It's all rounded.
Yeah, it's all.
And how is the Kenyan market for you? Are you first of all, are you targeting a specific age group? Are you targeting the youth, or you're just targeting everyone who can, or you don't have a target audience?
Okay, at the moment, I would say that first, I am a model myself, so the way I dress, I want to inspire the rest of the youths. Then, according to how I make my clothes, I want my clothes to be worn by every age group, so I want from the kids to everyone. So it's a matter of time. Yeah.
So about the market, how is it for you? What are the challenges? What are the advantages? How has it been for you? Market ilikuchukuaje?
So
was
far.
It so nice? Ilikukataa, inakukubali pole pole? So far so good.
Okay. To be honest, I started by thrifting clothes from Gikomba market.
Mm-hmm.
So I started with before I came up with my brand.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say the market has been good throughout, but now coming up with a brand is a different direction. So it's something that people have to take time to understand what I'm doing. Plus,
mm-hmm.
fashion in Kenya is not something that people have really appreciated for a long time.
Yeah.
So I would say that every designer from this country, seme ametoka shule, anataka kutengeneza kitenge, you know,
mm-hmm.
everyone wants to come up with a kitenge and African
mm-hmm.
designs. But now my style is a different one because I want to go beyond. Like, I want to come up with something which is beyond African taste, and it's beyond, like, everyone can cope with it.
Yeah.
So it's really hard for me to just fund myself. Of course, the challenges you talk about.
Yeah.
I would say financial challenges, of course. Because when you're funding yourself, it's a bit of struggle.
Yes.
And the crisis of a pandemic and everything around. So I would say that it's a bit of struggle, but it's all about coping with the situation and trying to let people know who you are and, of course, trying to get there.
Mm-hmm. So you are also open to shareholders if someone is interested in your brand, in whatever you make. You're open to shareholders?
Yeah, sure.
So that place where you said that you want your design to be something more, not only in Africa, not only in Kenya. So you also intend for it to go outside Kenya. So it's something everybody can wear.
Yeah, at the end of the day, that's
European can see it and know that I can do this, an African.
Yeah,
can
definitely.
Also wear
that's
it.
What I want to. I want to go global and beyond everyone else.
Wow.
Because right now we have social media, everyone is watching you. So you can just have your pieces around the world and yeah.
And where can people find you? Do you have a shop or you're just an online business? People just order online. Where can someone access you if they want your brands, your clothes?
Okay, at the moment, I think it's an order and pay then a delivery service. So you just can find me online, but we have various pickup stations, so you can come and collect your item. But our main focus is on the internet, on Instagram, on Facebook, yeah, and on WhatsApp, of course.
Oh.
Yeah. But soon we are coming up with a shop. So financial
nice,
status.
Nice.
That's very nice. So where do you see yourself in like 5 to 7 years? What's your vision?
Okay,
with
I
your
would
designs?
Say at the moment, I just want to go a bit by bit. I just want to see myself maybe the greatest. Maybe I want to see everyone in Kenya maybe copying my pieces.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see some attention from outside the country or even outside the world. Yes, and I want, of course, to inspire others to believe in themselves.
Nice.
Maybe
so are you mentoring anyone at the moment? Or are you teaching any young person? Are you educating anyone on your style or...?
Okay, I would say that maybe someone is watching me and still hoping to be like me, but I would say I'm not yet there. I'm still hoping for some good days and where I can inspire everyone else who wanna be a designer.
Wow, and don't trick. Is it an individual thing or you have some people?
Okay, don't trick itself. I would say I'm the one who started. And of course, but of course, I have a team with me who try to help me in marketing, managing my accounts. And of course, I have people around me who design for me. I myself, I know nothing about sewing. So I'm just a designer. So I have a team with me. So they come, I just give them the designs
mm-hmm.
and then they can make the exact make I want.
Oh,
wow.
That's
so
nice.
You're also creating employment outside.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
very nice.
That's nice. So it's a whole company itself. So that's good. So what advice would you give to upcoming designers?
Yes.
I would say that as an African or a black person, I would say that I want anyone to believe in themselves. Like to say, sai kila mtu ako like, I want to wear designers from Louis V, from Paris, from US, but naweza sema like Kenyans wanafaa wa focus on made in Kenya items like to support us in this thing. Like naweza waambia wangali wa try to support everything that is coming up from Kenyan industry. Not even clothes or maybe everything else, furniture and everything else.
Everything.
So like what we are trying to invest in our Kenyan brands so that we can get better day by day.
Kenyans for Kenya.
Yeah, Kenyans for Kenya.
That's nice.
And so we've come to the end of our show. Na hapo penye amesema it's about believing yourself. About the quote of the day, ni you have to believe on yourself for you to make everything happen. Because unless ujiaminia, hakuna mse mwingine atakuwa
aminia. It starts with you. It starts from inner belief, sindo?
Yeah.
It always starts from inner belief. So believe in yourself, guys. Don Tricks amesema yata kuenda shule ya designing.
Imagine. Sindo?
He didn't go to any design schools, but he's the one creating employment today. And he's the one making it in the Kenyan market, the Kenyan fashion market. It's so nice to have you. Thank you for coming. And we've come to the end of the show.
So don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms at Hearts Media TV, at Purity, at Ashira _ Star,
and at Ingasian _.
Alafu light skin leo haku make, but at Leo
Keyo Official.
We bring you one of the most trending styles, fashion and designs. You got it.